Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss regarding the structure of the C program. So now let us see what are the different components which are present in the structure of a C program. The very first component is preprocessor directive. Next one is global variable declaration. Next we do global constant declaration, void main or simply main. Main is a function. Then after main, we are going to open an opening flower bracket. Then if any comments are there, we are going to write. Then we do some local variable declaration. And then if any statements are there in the program, we write. Then the function call, if any function calls are there, we call them along with the parameters. And we just close the closing flower bracket. That is, we are closing this main function. Next, if any user defined functions are there, then we define those functions also. So this is the structure of the C program. Now let us see these components in detail one by one. So the very first component is preprocessor directive. What is meant by preprocessor directive? Means these directives are used to include the header files, that is the file containing all definitions and prototypes in the current program. So the meaning of this is, suppose we are using hash include stdio.h at the beginning of the program. That is a preprocessor directive. That is the header file. Suppose if we mention stdio.h, that is hash include stdio.h, stdio.h meant for standard input output header file, which is used to include the prototypes and definitions of the standard input and output functions. For example, stdio.h supports the printf and scanf functions. So some of the functions are going to be stored in this kind of preprocessor directive, and the supporting code will be present in preprocessor directive, and that we are going to make use in preprocessor directive. Next, the next part of the program structure is global variable declaration. So global variable declaration is nothing but, normally we declare some variable. Suppose we are doing addition operation, or suppose we are finding the area of some geometrical shapes. At the time, we are going to declare some variables. Suppose if I want to find the area of the triangle, then area of the rectangle and area of the some other geometric shape, I need to declare some common variable. So that kind of variable are called as global variable. That variable can be used by all the functions in our program. Normally it is declared before the main function. That kind of variables are called as global variable declaration. Next, global constant declaration. So like the variable declaration, we can do the global constant declaration also. So how means by using the hash define statement. Suppose we are doing the stack program, then hash define max 5. The size of the stack or size of the queue can be set to 5 by using this constant max. So hash define is mainly used to store some constant value. And you should observe hash define space max space 5. So like this, we are going to declare the global constants. Next, the next important component of the structure of C program is main function. In every C program, we will have the main function. Then what is the purpose of main function? The main function we are going to use because the program execution of every program will starts from the main function. Always the program execution starts from main. That's why we require main function. The next part is comments. Comment is nothing but it is just for our understandability, or for user understandability we use the comments. We can use the single line comment or double line comment. See, single line comment can be, if we use two forward slash and in front of that if we write anything, that is a single line comment. And forward slash star, then star, this forward slash, this indicates the multi-line comment. Inside this we can write the comments in many lines. So this single line and multi-line comments, they are mainly used for understandability, that is the program understandability. Suppose if we declare the variable A, then we can say this is the variable A, we are using this for so and so purpose in our program. So like that we should understand. Next, local variable declaration. Local variable declaration means in any function, within that function, if we declare some variable, that is called as local variable, and that variable is having scope only within that function. Outside that function, we cannot use local variable. Suppose inside the main, if I declare some variable, then I can use that variable only inside the main function. In other parts of the program, I cannot use that variable. That is, scope is only limited to main function. So this is the local variable declaration. And one more thing about the comments is, the comments are not going to be considered by the compiler for the execution. They are just for human readability. So I am going to explain what is meant by compiler in the later slides. Next, the next part of the program is statements. See, various type of input, output and control statements are present in the declaration of the variables. See, we are going to make use of many statements in our C program. Then the function call to perform specific action. If we want to add or if we want to subtract, the call will go to particular function. So it is all about the different parts which are present in the structure of the C program. Next, let us see very important concepts, compilation and linking. After writing the program and after if we come to know the structure of the C program, what happens? Let us see. First thing we need to concentrate is creation of the program. See, we use an editor to create or type a program which can make necessary correction using the editor and save the program on the secondary storage device such as hard drive. That is, first thing we need to type our program on any editor. So many editors has come, like Turbo C, then VI editor in our Linux, then code blocks editor, like that. And after typing the program, the file should save in the .c extension. The C file is going to save in .c extension. Suppose add is my program, then add.c is the file name. And Unix VI editor, Turbo C editor, code blocks editor are some of the example of the editors. The first step after creation is, the next step is pre-processing and compiling. So what is meant by pre-processing and compiling means, once if I have written the code, I need to compile that code. Compile means I need to check for the errors. So before doing compilation, I should do the pre-processing step. See, the compiler translate the C program into machine language code. Okay, so before this compilation, pre-processing is going to happen. And in the compilation process, what happens? The C program converted, that is C program in English like statement is converted into machine language code. And that machine language is called as the object code. Next, linking. What is meant by linking means, the C program contains reference functions and data defined in some other parts rather than the same program. Suppose I have a program, but its control is present in somewhere else. Okay, so it means the program may not be continuous. It might have broken. So in this one program, I have given reference to some other program which may present in some other folder or directory. So in that case, the object code produced by the compiler contains the gaps. So the linker helps in linking the object code with the code for the missing function to produce an executable file. This is the job of the linker, or this is called as linking. That is, if the program is not continuous, the program may give reference to some other program in some other place, and that time when the compilation happens, then the object code creates. In that object code, we have gaps. To fill that gaps, the linker will be used. And finally, an executable file will be created. Next, the next step is loading. After linking, compiling and linking, First up is creation of the program, next pre-processing and compilation, next one is linking, and next one is loading. See, before executing a program, it must be placed in memory. The loader takes executable files from disk and transferred it to memory. This is the next step. And the next step is, after loading, execution is the next step. In the execution part, the program is executed one instruction at a time. That is, instruction by if our program contains 10 lines, all the 10 lines will not execute at a time. One by one line is going to execute. And the next step is debugging. On execution, the compiler displays the list of errors, and these errors need to be rectified and are called the compile time errors. After execution, if any errors are there, it is going to display it on our screen, and these errors are called as compile time errors. And these errors may be syntax errors. We might have gone wrong in the syntax of the program. And also we have runtime errors also. Whenever the program is executing, we may get some errors like stack overflow, division by zero, error like that. So it's all about the debugging process. So once the debugging is over, again we are going to rectify the errors. Again we are going to compile it and we are going to execute. So now let us see whatever I have explained. That one we can see in this diagram. First step is, in the execution of a program, the very first step is write a C program in any one of your editors. It may be a Turbo C editor, it may be a CodeBlocks editor, or it may be a Unix VI editor or any other editor. So after that, after typing your program, give the program name by .c extension. As I told, if my program name is subtraction, give program name as sub.c. After typing the program and saving the program, next compile the program. After compilation and during compilation, what happens? The entire code is translated into object code by the compiler and stored as a file name .opt. Suppose sub.c is the file which has been compiled, then sub.object file will be created after compilation. Compilation is nothing but the English like statements are processed or converted back to machine level code. Machine level code is nothing but this object code. And after compilation, compiler links all function and operations with their respective header files. During the compilation process itself, it links, suppose if I use printf scanf function inside my program, that will be linked to hash include stdio.h header file. Like that, all the functions will be, operators will be linked to its header files. Okay, that's about the compilation steps. After that, compiler displays the errors, if any. As I told in previous, if any errors are there after compilation, it will display the error, and these errors are called as compile time errors, and that may be the syntax errors or the logical errors. And afterwards, the errors are rectified and the program is compiled again. If no errors, then the program runs successfully and the object code loaded into the memory and the program is executed. If the desired result is obtained, then fine. We are okay with the program and we executed the program successfully. Otherwise, we should consider there are runtime errors may present, and again we are going to go back to rectify the program. So it's all about the execution of the C program. Thank you. If you understanding the concepts, please like my video, subscribe and share. Thank you.